Maria Luraya, and I'm a director of Ufanisi Center. Ufanisi is a center which caters for orphans and vulnerable children at the slums of Korogocho. Ufanisi is actually a word which means prosperity. We chose the title because we wanted to give children hope that they'll prosper in future. So we started this center in 2008, June, and we started as a feeding program. Our main mission is to get orphans and vulnerable children towards realization of their potential through provision of basic needs, which include education, food, and clothing. And our vision is to have a community in which all children grow to realize their potential irrespective of their background. So when we started, we said that these children were suffering most because some of them didn't have food to take at home. They were not going to school. So we started this center to say that let them come here so that they can access those basic needs. So when we started as a feeding program, they were coming here every day. They take food, then they go back to their respective places. But afterwards, we saw because we were not able to access education to them, so introducing informal education. So we borrowed syllabus from the government, from the public schools, and some secondhand textbooks. So they were coming here, they also learned. So we teach them the same way others have been taught in private schools and in public schools. And we've seen them improving academically, because even by the end of the term, they do exams. And they do the same exams which have been done in other schools, and their performance is excellent. Our key achievements here to Ufanisi is that we've been able to accommodate more than 50 children, and we've seen improvement academically. They are able to read, maybe children at baby class, they are able to read letters, alphabetic codes. I mean, those in class one, they can read sentences and they can write well. Another achievement is that we've been able to provide food to them, because they've not been going hungry, although sometimes we miss finances, but we've been able to provide, and cases of malnutrition which they were suffering before, now those cases have been reduced. And we also have some partners who came in, like Big Kids Australia. They were co-contributing to our feeding program. Another achievement is that we had partners like Nabila Abdul Malik, who was the head of communications at FemNet. She was very supportive to us. She provided some computers, financial assistance, and stationery to the children. And we also had a French embassy in Kenya. They also came in and provided some foodstuffs for the children. So I also want to congratulate the team of volunteers who I work with for their commitment to make sure that they get quality education. Challenges which we face here, one is that we don't have our own land, because the structures which we are using are rental. So you find some times we have been evicted by the structure owners. They come and they tell us that we need to leave their premises. And also the place is not very conducive for learning environment. We don't have a plain ground. And when it rains, the rain leaks in the room. And sometimes children are in the middle of classes, lessons. So you find it is hard for them to concentrate. So that is the main challenge. And also we are using one room, all different classes, one room. We've not been able to get enough rooms to put them according to their strengths. The other challenge is feeding program, because we don't have a regular donor who is funding us. So we find sometimes we don't have something to provide for them. So those are the main two challenges. Another core challenge is like stationery, because we provide them with books and writing materials. So sometimes you find when the books they've been finished, a child can go without learning because she or he doesn't have a book. So we are looking forward, maybe in our future plans, to purchase a piece of land, then construct for them good classes where each stream we have, they'll be sitting on their own, to have a facility with running water, and for them to just have a conducive environment for learning. My name is Isaiah Luyara, and I'm a visionary.